Come on. It's really great. Hey, Chris, can you come? She won't accept the charges? Talk her into it. Hey, Chris? Come on. You can't do this to me.
I've been waiting. Did she hang up?
Oh.
This has been declared a disaster area because I called long distance to Buffalo and asked some cats there. And like they said that it definitely has been declared a disaster area. So like I don't think
you're... Is there any way to get out?
They're trying to evacuate it today.
Huh?
They're trying to evacuate it today, so maybe late tonight, you know, like 1.
How are they going to evacuate it?
We're not sure. I think they're trying to get all the cats in the cars and just direct the cars to get out.
When I got a call from the state police that they were having trouble on state roads. They had an authority problem because all these people were so desperate to get to our concert that they weren't going to believe anybody, whether they were in uniform or not. They needed somebody from the show to tell them that they weren't going to be able to get in to see the concert, so that they might as well turn around. So I said, okay, I'll go out and do this. Traffic jams are usually sort of orderly things, but this was more like a traffic chaos, as if somebody had taken a giant salt shaker full of cars and sprinkled them around on the road, and there was no chance that we were going to break this one up. I saw a trooper with his hat earnestly talking to somebody through the open window of this fellow's car. And the fellow was saying, you know, he was adamant he wasn't going to, and I said to this fellow, my name's Joel Rosenman, I'm a producer of this show, and I can tell you that we are admitting no more people to the show. You will not be able to get in. This was not exactly true in the sense that... But I promised that I would say this, and in a way it was true. He wouldn't be able to get in past our ticket gates because there were no ticket gates. And he said, all right. And there was a lot of backing and creating inches and more inches and more inches of space until finally this guy was able to move his car, you know, with about a 27-point turn. He finally got himself pointed around the other way south and managed to leave. This took about, I guess, an hour and 15 minutes. And we had turned around one car. And there were roughly 130,000 cars.
Okay. I guess the reason we're here is music. Well, let's have some music. Ladies and gentlemen, Quill.
What does it cost to put one of these things together?
$2 million.
In cost? And in other words, you have to make $2 million to break even?
Well, if we are going to break even, you know, point is that it's happened and it's working, you know?
Yeah.
That's enough for now.
Thank you. By the way, there's a gentleman by the name of Abby Hoffman who's helped us a great deal here. He'll probably be mad that I say that. But he's worked very hard to help a lot of people in a lot of ways.
And Abby Hoffman was a brilliant deviant, a wonderfully imaginative, creative guy. Bust it up, break it down, make fun of it, ridicule it, destroy it, whatever, just for the heck of it. See what happens. Went to see Abby on his request, an invitation that one doesn't refuse. And I got to his East Village office, which looked like an abandoned kindergarten room. And there behind the teacher's desk was Abby. He was flanked on one side by a huge sort of Jaws-type individual, and on the other side by an attack dog. And Abby, and I said, look, you know, I knew that I better open and sort of establish the rule of reason in this discussion. And I said, look, Abby, you know, that I know that you would like to make a big presentation at Woodstock, but it isn't that kind of a show. It's rock and roll, and it's really a weekend of peace and music. And he said, I don't give a damn about that. You guys write a big check to my organization, and we're cool. What are you talking about? He said, here's what I'm talking about, $10,000.
I think they started to chant. I forget who started the chant. Either John and Joel started the chant or the people in the room started the chant. I'm a little vague on that. But we went in and we sat down and we put a deal together where we'd give them, I think we offered them $10,000. First we said, listen, if you really want to help, then, you know, why don't you just, we'll give you money, but we'll give you money to come and put out a newsletter and let people know how to sort of get through the weekend if that's really your concern. And they liked that idea a lot, and they agreed to do it. I think they eventually, they did bring a printing press, and they probably spent some of the money on what we were doing.
10 years for two joints, man. Free John Sinclair, the sky is the limit. Find out what's happening in Ann Arbor, man, or anywhere for that matter.
What is happening anywhere?
The same scene that's happening here, man. The most flipped out scene the United States has ever seen. Really, it's never happened anything like this. It's unreal. The power of the people is just first starting to be imagined in some people's heads. The things that we never could have believed.
Ladies and gentlemen, Malcolm.
take it higher. Wanna take it higher.
Are you mad? Are you okay? You're not, yeah, you're staying stoned and you got enough water and you got a place to sleep and everything? What does that mean? Because, you know, because we ought to, all of us, you know, I don't mean to be preachy, but we ought to remember, and that means promoters too, that music's for grooving, man, and music's not for putting yourself through bad changes. You know, I mean, you don't have to go take anybody's shit, man, just to like music. You know what I mean? You don't. So so if you're getting more shit than you deserve, you know what to do about it, man. You know, it's just music. Music's supposed to be different than that. Try just a little bit harder. Better, baby. And you know you got it. Try. looking all around me. I said, everywhere I looked, I saw the rain. It wasn't nothing else. It wasn't your tears. It felt to me like the rain. Something grabbed a hold of me. Felt to me all night. I wanted to tears. I wanted to do, you know what I felt like? I didn't feel just like it. Because I got to have it. Does it almost want to go and have me, baby? Ah, no, 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 no. Whoa, 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 oh. And it can't be. I said it just can't be. Never, 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 never. Here you go today, and honey, I wanted to hold you, I wanted to love you for so long, but you know that's all I ever wanted, babe, was to just hold on to you, love you, I wasn't gonna hurt you. I said, whoa, 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 honey, this can't be, no, this can't, whoa, honey, this can't be, babe. You can tell me. Oh, I said sometimes that I got to know why. And sometimes, babe, I said I feel that I need to know why. Tell me if I wanna ask you now. I said tell me if I wanna lean on. I said if I wanna put my arm around. I said, I want a little help sometimes. I need a little help sometimes. Baby, 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 yeah. Wow. Baby, 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 yeah. I said, I got to know why. I said, why? Does it want to pull me down, babe? I said, does it want to drag me around? Feels to me just like a bone. I said, da 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 da, it was a bone. Oh, and a chain.
By late on Saturday, even the least perceptive of the business managers for the bands began to realize that we might be in some kind of financial trouble. We got a call, I guess around midnight, and the two managers of the Grateful Dead and The Who called up and said, the rumor's going around that you guys are broke, and your check is no longer going to do the job. We need cash. So I said, hey, guys, I mean, I understand that you're concerned, but It's Saturday night around midnight. There's no way I can get cash, so let's work this out tomorrow. You have your band play, and we'll make good on it. Don't worry. And he said, we're worried. And your word, your check, is not going to do it. We need cash or cashier's checks. Finally, I said, well, let's call Charlie Prince. It can't hurt. Maybe he'll come up with a bright idea. And he said, is there any chance that you can get your hands on $50,000 for me? And he said, I don't think there is. He said, we lock everything up in the time vault, and the teller's checks, the cashier's checks, all the cash, all the, and he said, wait a second. He said, I'm not sure. He said, I was just going through it in my mind as I was saying it, and there is one drawer of cashier's checks that I may not have locked up on Friday night. It's a possibility. I don't remember actually doing it. So let me go take a look. I said, Charlie, this is so great. Can you call me? He said, sure, I can. He said, how do I get there? He said, the last time I tried to get anywhere, it was impossible. He said, I'll take care of that. Just wait out in your backyard and I'll send a helicopter. I hung up and I got a helicopter up in the air and over to Charlie's in about 20 minutes. And he was waiting there in his bathrobe, and it looked like a scene from Close Encounters, and the chopper comes down and picks him up and flies him over to the White Lake branch. And when he got into the bank, the first thing he did was pick up the phone and call me and tell me that he was in the bank and he was going to start looking around. He said, I'm going to put the phone down on the desk and I'll come back to you as soon as I find these checks. And put the phone, I could hear him rummaging around in the bank, where are these, and clattering. And then I hear, yeah, I found them. And I think, oh, and in our White Lake office, everybody went, yay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Who. Thank you very much indeed. We'd like to play a song which kind of is our, we knew we were going to come back and do it. And this is a, yeah, sorry. This is kind of our hymn. It's a song about you and me. We're getting a bit old now. A song called My Generation.
What we all talking about, my generation. I'm trying to cause a big sensation. Just talking about my generation. My generation,
Ladies and gentlemen, The Who. We'll continue with the Jefferson Airplane.
All right, friends, you have seen the heavy groups. Now you will see Morning Maniac music. Believe me, yeah. It's a new dawn. Yeah, the regular guys.
Truth is mine. morning, and the ones that your mother gives you don't do anything.
See the final part of the diary tomorrow night on BBC Two, starting at 11:35.
Leave the city or the forest, and further on, leave the wagon of the morning, dusty road where they have gone. Sometimes traveling through the darkness, met the summer coming home.